Yeah, watching Poland Daily Business, and on the portal businessalert.pl we can read that the government is going to shut 13 coal mines, and the chief editor of the portal, Wojciech Jakubik, is our guest tonight. Sir, welcome to the show.
Hi.
Well, by the way, we should say that there is an English version of this
yes.
portal.
So businessalert.com.
Yeah, you can check by yourself what is hot in Polish economy, in Polish business. And definitely the perspective of closing down 13 coal mines is an important news. And this is only because Poland has to comply with the Green New Deal that is championed by the European Commission?
Not only, because the economic feasibility of coal mining in Poland is decreasing because of natural circumstances like geology, which makes it more and more expensive and more dangerous, so also expensive, to produce coal in Poland. And in long term, it is natural to get off the coal industry in Poland. And we have another step towards this direction. And of course, the climate agenda, which we agreed upon inside the European Union, is speeding up this process, because the goal of this process is to decarbonize whole economy, starting with energy sector. So we are looking for some solution now, because Poland are not willing to have a green revolution tomorrow. They show that they are starting from different starting point than, for example, Germany. We need more time, more money to have it. That's why we are discussing about this just transition fund to make those coal reliant regions rearrange, to change their economy from coal to different sectors. And that's why we need a huge investment, not only closing down those mines, but also some alternative like e-mobility, other sectors that are willing to give jobs to people that are looking for some alternative, and they need to get a clear plan for next decade.
Yeah, because the bottom line is that we need jobs for people who are working in Silesia. That's the most populous part of Poland. And definitely the coal mining jobs are rather high paying. Those are specialists, very skilled people. So what we will do with those people? What offers is what offer is going to be given to them?
Okay, so we have a possibility of quitting the job and getting pay even until death. It is discussed that people who are willing to quit the coal job will get paid until their natural demise. There is also discussion about some change, for example, to give such people a job inside e-mobility sector, inside other sectors that are developing in Silesia. It's not like Silesia is only having those coal jobs. There are different innovative jobs already, and the government is announcing new e-mobility factories, new factories of different kinds, like energy storage and so on. That is also an alternative for such people. And the third solution is some kind retirement with some payment, which is going to make such people go retired and then get some money to have a steady life.
We assume that Polish economy will develop even 2020 with this amazing growth of Polish export means that there is a place for Polish goods and services on the world markets. But obviously the growth of production and productivity is associated directly with the level of energy spending, and with when we are closing down the mines, we will also close down the power stations. So how Poland will supplement that lack of fuel in the system?
So we have an agency of national energy security to be created to sustain the most important part of coal sector, like coal generation, coal production, which is needed to provide the energy security. So it's not like we'll switch off everything and stay without power. The goal is to preserve the important part of coal sector, which is really necessary from the point of view of energy security. But in the meantime, we need to create a new generation which is less emittant, like nuclear energy, like gas generation, and also renewables, photovoltaics, the wind farms, and so on, which will provide new generation which is okay with EU regulations.
But this is definitely expensive, and this will,
of course,
push up the energy price, the utility prices in Poland.
In the end, it should decrease the energy prices because our energy prices are already high. Those are increasing all over Europe, but in Poland we have a huge problem with increased prices because of the climate policy and also the problems with economic feasibility of coal sector. So in like 10, 15 years, we'll have a decreased prices of energy because of this new generation, which is more effective, which is more reliant on climate policy. And that's how we want to have a bigger economic competitiveness of Polish economy.
Right. The importing the power from countries like Sweden or Germany when it's produced from the natural or renewables is obviously natural and understandable. Why Poland is cautious when offered the power from nuclear power from Ukraine or Belarus?
Well, we want to have our own generation in Poland. We don't want to be too dependent on external resources. Of course, if we need more energy, we can import it anytime. We can get it from Germany, from Scandinavia already. So Belarus or Ukraine sources are nothing new. It's not bringing any change to Polish situation. We need to have our own generation and we need to plan it very well. We need to have decision in 2022 when it comes to nuclear power plant. We need to have a resolution finally after so many years of discussion, and then we need to find solution from for wind farms on the sea, like offshore wind farms, which are to be built until 2025, then the gas power plants, which are to supplement the renewables in Poland, and then we'll have a cheaper generation, cheaper energy prices, and higher competitiveness of Polish economy.
So we will see. The 2022 is only next year, so it's really time to make a crucial decision now. Wojciech Jakubikow, Business Alert portal, was our guest, and you will find out the Business Alert version in English also on the same address, right? businessalert.pl or businessalert.com. Thank you very much for this conversation. That was it for Poland Daily Business tonight. Please tune in tomorrow because we will be back.